Namaskaram, Sadhguru. I have read about the significance of the magnetic equator and how mystical spaces like the Chidambaram Nataraja temple was established on that line in ancient times. Why is the magnetic equator important for seekers?
When we say the magnetic equator, what we're talking about is a sort of zero influence of the North Pole and the South Pole. Magnetic equator means neither the pull of the North nor the South has much influence on you. You're in a kind of a place where it's kind of zero. So this allows, when you're at the magnetic equator, it allows your energies to take it upward, it becomes much easier because nothing is being skewed. If you're in the northern pole, the northern pole is there in a certain way, so your system is always trying to adjust to that. It's like if you're driving your car, little alignment problems in the wheels, it's constantly pulling, but you can manage, you know. No car, except maybe like Formula One racing things on the track, except them, no car is really perfectly aligned. All of them are pulling either right or left. But it may be very mild that you don't mind, most people never notice it, first of all. If you take your hands off and drive, it won't go straight. It'll go straight for some time and then it'll go, but then there's also no perfect road. There is no such thing as a perfect plain road, so the road also may be acting, but whichever way, it's quite… it's not impossible, but near impossible to align four wheels perfectly. Such a thing doesn't happen in a normal commercial car, it's not possible. Racing cars, they're trying to get it there because the speeds that they're touching is so high, if the alignment is not there, that little minor alignment problem can take away a few seconds off the corners for a race driver. So they're working on getting perfect, absolutely perfect alignment. I don't know even if they achieve an absolutely perfect alignment, but near perfect alignment they manage. So when you're at magnetic equator, you are at near perfect alignment magnetically. That means there is no pull to the south, no pull to the north. That means your energies are free to move upward, and also because of the centrifugal force, it moves upward. That means life is dancing at its best. So Nataraja is established there to show life is at its peak here. If you're here and you do the right things, your life is at its peak, dance performance. When we say dance, we're always thinking of… I don't know what you're thinking. I don't know, you're the rock and roll type or the hip-hop type or the ballroom kind or the Bharatanatyam kind. We don't know what kind you are, because when we say dance, for different people means different things. So, essentially dance means effervescence. Doing stylishly, doing this and that is not dance, that's a show-off. Dance means effervescence. Life is at its best. So today, physicists in the world are trying to describe the play of subatomic particles as a dance of particles. And you know, the Nataraja statue has been established in front of CERN. The… you know, where this… they're trying to collide atoms as if there is not enough collision on the planet. So, that is indicative of the dance of subatomic particles which makes the whole existence happen the way it is. So, because it's zero magnetism, there is no pull or push from either side, and because of the centrifugal force that is working at that latitude, at the highest possible… in almost nearly vertical movement, life is at its peak. And if you're doing the right things with your life is highly effervescent. The very… from this comes the word samskriti, which means to be equanimous, equanimity. The magnetic equator is indicating the equanimity and to be exuberant. So at the highest level of exuberance and the best possible equanimity, the alignment is great, speed is good, that's a winner. So that's why one dimension of Shiva in the Chidambara temple is shunya or emptiness. People are talking about it as akash, it is for one of the elements. That dimension is also there because it's the nearest thing that people know in physical experience of life to stillness is akash. All the other elements are in a certain state of dynamism. Akash seems to be still, it is not entirely still, but it seems to be still. Among the elements, this is the most still and silent element. So there is worship of akash and there is a process which is emptiness or I'm sorry, shunya. Shunya means beyond physical nature and there is a dance, all three in one temple to indicate that this is what it is prepared for, that space. And they chose the right kind of geographical location to make this happen.